Hello friends, welcome back to my channel Chemistry Unplugged. In this video, we will discuss about sigmatropic rearrangement, selection rule, stereochemistry, some tricks, Cope rearrangement and Claisen rearrangement with lots of examples. So, sigmatropic shift is shifting of sigma electrons across pi electron conjugated system, and it involves shifting of sigma as well as pi electrons. For example, in propene, hydrogen atoms show shifting from this carbon atom to this carbon atom. So, it is 1,3 sigmatropic shift. To name the sigmatropic shift, we have to first identify migrating group and then we identify alkenyl chain. Alkenyl chain is a chain which containing allylic carbon. So, for example, we have this molecule. So, first we identify allylic carbon and we will give it number 1. The carbon atom of migrating group which is attached to allylic group is also given number 1. So, in this molecule, we will give it number 1, then 2, 3. This whole chain is shifting from here to here. Then, this sigma bond will move here and this pi bond will go here. So, it is a 1,3 sigmatropic carbon shift. First number, that is 1, is number of atom of migrating group, and second number, that is 3, is the number of carbon atom on which migrating group is going to attach. So, it is a 1,3 sigmatropic rearrangement. Now, let's take some examples to identify their name or naming a sigmatropic rearrangement. First example is this. So, first we have to identify alkenyl chain. So, it is an allylic carbon. We will give it number 1, then 2, 3. This is a migrating group. So, oxygen is giving number 1, 2 and then 3. So, this migrating group is moving from this pi bond will move from here to form a sigma bond. So, this is a pattern of movement of sigma and pi electrons. So, it is a 3,3 sigmatropic shift. Then, in next example, we first identify allylic carbon. This is allylic carbon. We will give it number 1, then 2, 3. And sulfur is giving number 1. It is a migrating group 1 and it is giving number 2. So, this negative charge will move from here to form a sigma bond. So, it is an example of 2,3 sigmatropic shift. Then, in next example, we again find out alkaline chain and migrating group. It is a pattern of movement of electrons. So, it is a 3,3 sigmatropic shift. So, how we identify a sigmatropic shift will be suprafacial or enterofacial. Suprafacial means atom is going to attach on the same side as in the reactant. Okay. And in enterofacial, the atom will attach in the opposite direction. So, first we identify selection rule for sigmatropic hydrogen shift. If the number of electrons in transition state in reactant is 4n, or you can identify it on the basis of curved arrows. If curved arrows are even, then it is a 4n system. Or if it is 1,3 sigmatropic shift, means sum of 1 and 3, 1 plus 3 is 4, it is 4n. N is equals to 1, then it is a 4n system. 1,7 sigma shift is 8, that is, it is also a 4n system. So, in the 4n system, if activation is through heat, then this shift will be enterofacial. And if it is a photochemically excited, then symmetry will be suprafacial. In 4n plus 2 system, Again, we identify 4n plus 2 system using 1, 5. 1 plus 5 is 6. It is 4n plus 2 system. 1 plus 9 is equals to 10. It is also a 4n plus 2 system. If it is excited through heat, then symmetrically it will be suprafacial. And if it is excited through UV radiations, then it will be entrafacial. But in case of hydrogen, entrafacial is not geometrically allowed. It is geometrically forbidden because hydrogen atom is small in size, so it cannot attach to the positive as well as negative lobe of the p orbitals. If you want to understand it in more detail, you can ask me in the comment section. So sigmatropic intrafacial hydrogen shift is geometrically forbidden. Symmetrically it is allowed, but geometrically forbidden. So we have to remember only that for the 4N system, if the excitation is through UV radiation, then it is superficially allowed, and for the 4N plus 2 system, activation is through the heat for superficial shift. So in the first example, we excite the system through heat. So first we have to find out which type of sigmatropic rearrangement it is. So it is a allylic carbon, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And for the hydrogen, we will give it 1. So it is a 1,5 sigmatropic shift, means it is a 4N plus 2 system. 1 plus 5 is 6, means it is a 4N plus 2 system. For the 4N plus 2 system, if the activation is through heat, then hydrogen will be suprafacially shifted. So its direction of attachment will not change. First we have to identify which type of shift it is. So it is an allylic carbon. We will give it number 1, then 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And hydrogen is giving number 1. So it is a 1,7 sigmatropic shift. 1,7 means 1 plus 7. That is 8. 8 means it is 4N system. And for 4N system, if we heat it, it is allowed, activated by heat, then it is symmetrically, it is entrafacial. Means if hydrogen is attached in this direction, means if it is above the plane, then in the product, after sigmatropic rearrangement, it will be below the plane. So it is entrafacially attached. It is only symmetrically allowed. But this reaction is not possible because it is not feasible geometrically. Then selection rule for sigmatropic carbon shift. Again, we have 4N system, and if we give heat, it is entra retention, means entrafacial with retention in configuration, and if we give light, then suprafacial retention. If it is also possible, if we give heat, it is also possible by suprafacial inversion, and for the light, entrafacial inversion. So it is very difficult to remember this table. So I usually remember only 4 for the 4N system, TSI and PSR. We will only remember for the suprafacial rearrangement. Entrafacial will be opposite of it. TSI is T for thermal, S means suprafacial, I means inversion, P means photochemically excited, S again superficial, R is retention. So you can only remember this for the 4N system, TSI and PSR. For 4N plus 2 system, TSR, PSI. So first we take this example. Again we have to find it, identify allylic system. It is an allylic carbon. We will give it number 1, then 2, 3. And it is a carbon shift. So this carbon is going to be shifted from here to carbon 3. So we will give it number 1. So it is 1,3 sigmatropic carbon shift. 1,3 means it is 4N system. 1 plus 3, 4. 4N system. So if we give it heat, for 4N system, TSI means if it is activated through heat, suprafacial inversion. So in this system, O-acetyl and deuterium atom D are trans to each other. So after this rearrangement, they will be cis to each other. It is inversion in configuration after rearrangement. So first we take Cope rearrangement. Cope rearrangement is a type of sigmatropic rearrangement. It is 3-3 carbon-carbon sigmatropic rearrangement. It is a thermal rearrangement of 1,5 dienes. It is a characteristic reaction of 1,5 diene. So in this example, it is 1,5 diene. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1,5 diene, it is heated, then electron will shift by 3,3 sigmatropic rearrangement. We will have the same structure. So if after the rearrangement, after Cope rearrangement, the structure of product and reactants are same, then it is called as degenerate Cope rearrangement. Degenerate means they both of them have same structure. So Cope rearrangement is considered to through chain shaped diradical transition state. Usually pericyclic reactions are concerted in nature. These they are single step reactions, but it is considered that it is go through a chair shaped diradical transition state. Then 1,3,5 hexatriene also show Cope rearrangement. It is a 1,5 diene, so it can also show Cope rearrangement, but it is a modified Cope rearrangement because the structure of reactant and product are not same. It is not degenerate, it is modified Cope rearrangement. And only cis isomer of 1,3 hexatriene can show this type of rearrangement, because in the trans, the bonds are far away from each other, so they cannot, it is not feasible for sigma and pi electrons to move. Then what will be the stereochemistry of a product after Cope rearrangement? For example, this is a molecule in which methyl and OH group are trans to each other, and it is a EE type of molecule. EE means for this double bond, these two groups are trans, or we can say it E. When they are in same direction, it is called Z. For both the double bonds, the methyl groups are opposite in direction to this group attached. So it is a EE type of molecule. So first we will number it. So after numbering it, we can write down it in the form of chair shaped. The methyl and OH group are trans to each other, so they will be equatorial in position. Generally, the functional group try to be in equatorial position in the chair shaped molecule. If they both of them are equatorial in nature, means they are trans. If both of them are axial, then they are also trans. But if methyl is axial and OH is equatorial, then it is cis. For the 1,2 carbon atom, the AA or EE is trans, AE, EA are cis. So these, the methyl and OH group are trans to each other. Similarly, this double bond is, for this double bond, methyl and this group are trans or E. So similarly, we are following it here. So we will place this methyl group in equatorial direction, and same for this methyl group. So they both of them are equatorial direction. So these two methyl group will be equatorial and equatorial in nature. So after the sigmatropic shift, this will be the transition state. These two, this bond will break and new sigma bond will form here. So in the product, these two methyl groups will be trans to each other. If one is above the plane, other will be below the plane. So if we take, in the next example, we will take EZ type of molecule. This methyl group is E to this double bond, and this methyl group is Z to this double bond. The groups, both the heavier groups are on the same side. So if we can write down it like this, these two, the methyl and OH group, are equatorial and equatorial because they are trans, and because this methyl group is E to double bond and this methyl group is Z to this double bond. So they are, one is equatorial and other is axial. Means in the product, they will be cis to each other because they are AE type. We will take another example of Cope's rearrangement. Cis-1,2-divinyl-cyclopropane. This is a very important example of Cope rearrangement. And in this molecule, after the rearrangement, heptadiene will form. Cis-2-divinyl-cyclopropane can be exist in two forms. In one form, the first form is more stable, in which vinyl groups points away the cyclopropane ring and syn hydrogens. It is more stable in nature. In second form, these two vinyl group point towards the ring and towards the syn hydrogen. It is less stable and it is known as coiled form. But the first form cannot show Cope's rearrangement. Only coiled form can show Cope's rearrangement. And in cis-1,2-divinyl-cyclopropane, the transition state is boat-like instead of chair-like. Then we have another example, homopropylidene. It is another example of degenerate Cope's rearrangement because the reactant and the product have same structures. So here is a tip that 1,5-diene with cis symmetry and have coiled structures can easily give Cope rearrangement, and even at room temperature. Generally, for the Cope rearrangement, we require temperature of up to 200 to 300 degrees centigrade. But for the cis symmetry and coiled structures, this reaction can occur even at room temperature. And if an electron withdrawing group is present at carbon 3 and carbon 4, then this reaction is more feasible in the forward direction. It will not be reversible, but it will be one-sided reaction. And why this reaction is in the forward direction? Because for electron withdrawing group, this double bond will form a conjugated system, means it is more stable. Product is more stable than reactant, then the reaction will be in the forward direction. Then oxy-cope rearrangement. So 1,5-diene, when substituted with OH and OR group at carbon 3 and or 4th position. So for this example, this will be the 3,3 sigmatropic shift, and in the product, OH group is attached with this carbon with double bond. So it can show tautomerism and it will be converted into unsaturated carbonyl. So let's take another example of oxy-cope rearrangement. So it is a 1,5-diene, 1,2,3,4,5. It is a 1,5-diene with OH group present at carbon 3. So after rearrangement, this will be the product, and upon tautomerism, we have this as a final product. But the oxy-cope rearrangement requires very high temperature, and it is not feasible to maintain very high temperature. So we have another substitute of it, that is anionic oxy-cope rearrangement. For anionic oxy-cope rearrangement, we will convert this OH group in O minus group. We will use a strong base like potassium hydride. So we have this O minus and K plus. Then we will do the same 3,3 sigmatropic shift, And upon tropotomerase, we will have the same product as in case of oxy-cope rearrangement. Let's take an example. This reactant first react with potassium hydride, give A, and upon heated will give B, and finally C. So first we will react with potassium hydride. So let's try to find out, is it a 1,5-diene? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It is a 1,5-diene. Then we will number it. Okay. Heated means it will be sigmatropic rearrangement. So we will find out first allylic carbon and then migrating group. So it will be 3,3 sigmatropic shift. So after the shift, we will this as a product, and on the reaction with H plus, we will have OH minus here, and upon tautomerase, it will give it product C. Then Eshenmoser-Cope rearrangement. Eshenmoser-Cope is also a 3,3 sigmatropic shift with iminium compound. In iminium compound, nitrogen is attached with carbon by double bond, and it is also carrying a positive charge. And on 3,3 sigmatropic shift, it gives Eshenmoser-Cope rearrangement. In the exams, Eshenmoser-Cope rearrangement is often given with manic reaction, which we will discuss later. Then we have Claisen rearrangement. Claisen rearrangement is given by 1,5-diene containing oxygen atom. It is also 3,3 sigmatropic rearrangement and thermally induced. 3,3 means 3 plus 3 is 6 means 4N plus 2 system. And for the 4N plus 2 system, when the reaction is thermally induced, we will use TSR. TSR means thermally induced, S means superficial, and R is with retention in configuration. So, first example of Claisen rearrangement is allyl phenyl ether. So, we will number it again, and it will show this rearrangement, which upon tautomerase will give final product. But if we use allyl phenyl thioether, it cannot give Claisen rearrangement. But amino derivative of it can show Claisen rearrangement. Allyl vinyl ether can also show Claisen rearrangement, and it is known as aliphatic Claisen rearrangement or Claisen-cope rearrangement. This is the allylic group CH2, CH double bond CH2. This is a vinyl group CH double bond CH2. So we will number it again, and it is a 3,3 sigmatropic shift Claisen rearrangement. So for the Claisen rearrangement for allyl vinyl ether, we require a allyl alcohol and vinyl alcohol to form allyl vinyl ether. But vinyl alcohol is not stable. So for the synthesis of allyl vinyl ether, we can use different reactions. First is acetal of acetaldehyde and methanol. It can react with allyl alcohol in presence of propionic acid to give allyl vinyl ether, which can give Cope-Claisen rearrangement. Then we can also use orthoesters. Orthoesters show similar reaction and can form and can show Claisen rearrangement to form gamma delta unsaturated esters. It is known as Johnson-Claisen rearrangement. And if we use orthoamides, then orthoamides can show Eshenmoser Claisen rearrangement. Allyl vinyl ether can also be prepared from allyl alcohol and acetyl chloride in presence of pyridine. First we will react these two molecules in presence of pyridine. Then we will use lithium diisopropyl amide. It is a strong base and can cause removal of protons from alpha carbon of carbonyl compounds. In case of unsymmetrical ketones, it removes proton from less substituted carbon. On using LDA, it will remove, this is the alpha carbon, so it will remove one hydrogen from here and form a double bond. We can also write down it like this, and it can show Claisen rearrangement, and this ally can be removed using HIs. And we have gamma delta unsaturated carboxylic acids. And we can also use, instead of a mild acid, we can use trimethyl selenium chloride, and then it can show Claisen rearrangement, and after the rearrangement we can react it with acid to form a gamma delta unsaturated carboxylic acid. It is called Ireland-Claisen rearrangement. Then beta keto esters. This is a beta keto ester because it is a alpha carbon, it is beta carbon, and ketone group is present at beta carbon. So beta keto, and it is a ester group. Beta keto esters can show tautomeres to form. This will become a double bond, and it is a OH group. So it is a 1,5-diene with oxygen atom. So it can show Claisen rearrangement. We will number it, and it can show this Claisen rearrangement. This will be the final product, and this COOH can remove CO2, and we will have this as a final product. It is a gamma delta unsaturated ketone. It is known as Kimel-cope rearrangement. It is a very useful reaction to form gamma delta unsaturated ketones. So what is the stereochemistry of the product in the Claisen rearrangement? Similar to Cope rearrangement, we will use EE type of compound. So in the EE type of the compound, these two methyl group will become equatorial, and if they both of, for the 1,2 carbon, if two substituents are equatorial in nature, then in the product they will be trans. So for the EE type or ZZ type, in the product the substituents will be trans to each other, and for the EZ or ZE type of the product, one methyl will go axial, another will go equatorial. So both of, for 1,2 carbon in a chair shaped structure, AE, axial equatorial, are cis in nature. So in the product they are either below the plane, both of them will be below the plane, or above the plane. So that's it. I will end my today's video here. It is already very lengthy video. So I will discuss questions from the competitive exams and 2-3 sigmatropic shift in my next video. I will upload my next video on Thursday. I hope this video will be helpful to you to understand about the various sigmatropic shift and stereochemistry of the product. So thank you so much for watching my channel. Please subscribe my channel if you have not subscribed it, and press bell icon for future notifications.